Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you how we can draw SNP linkage disequilibrium heat map using this SR plot website. And here in this LD heat map block, you can see we have a total physical length of genome that is 8.9 kb in this case. And here in this blue color, it is representing the name of those SNPs. And here each line is representing one SNP. So as we know that LD heat map are very essential for the selection of haplotype analysis. So if we want to know what is the correlation of any SNP to any other SNP, it can be represented through this R square color key. So as the correlation will be high, so its color would be more and more orange. But if the correlation value would be low, so its color would be blue. So let's suppose if we want to see this SNP, how this is correlated with this. So if we take this SNP and this SNP, so they are combining at this position. So it means it is showing the R square value in the middle, because here you can see this SNP and this SNP is showing this color. So it means it has only the medium correlation. But if we see this SNP is correlated with this SNP, so like this SNP is correlated with this, so it is showing high correlation R square value. So it means this SNP has more correlation with this SNP. So in this example, I will show you how you can also prepare your input data and you can draw your LD heat map for free using this SR plot website. So let me show you how you can approach to this website. So first of all, you can open this website bioinformatics.com.cn/english. So here you can see now this SR plot website is visible, and now you can go and click on this heat map. And in this heat map, you will see this, there is SNP likelihood. So you can simply click on this. So here you can your input data and you can draw your SNP LD heat map. So you can prepare your data in the form of this. So here you can see the first column is showing the position of that SNP, and the second row is showing the name of that SNP. So here you can enter all the information of SNP change of your all genotypes. And here you would see that if you don't have any information, so you can simply write NA at that place if you don't have any information of that SNP. So when you have prepared your data, you can simply copy all that SNP including their header, and you can go to that website and you can simply input your data here. So when you have done, you can here optimize your figure size. For this example, you can simply select figure width and figure height. You can select the lowest color. If you want to change, you can simply go here and change if you want. And if you want to change the high color, so in this example, we can choose the red one. And here you can choose the color number, and here you can choose what you want to write here. And here are the labeled SNP names. So in this example, here we have these SNP names. So we know that if you want to write all those SNPs, so you can simply copy all. But in this example, I will write only maybe two or three. Like we want to write only this one. I will simply copy this. So here, and you can separate with the help of comma. And next, let's suppose we only want to mention this one. But if you want to mention all, you can simply write all and separate them with the help of comma. So next we want this one. So now you can simply select the SNP name size, and you can select font family. So this figure will consume 1 point, and whenever you will register this website, so you will get 3 points. You can use them to draw your figure. So because now we have input our all required data, so we can simply click on the submit button. So now you can see our LD heat map is ready, and it is showing the three SNPs which we have just entered. And you can download in the form of PNG, PDF, or SVG. So in this example, we can simply download in the form of PDF. So here you can see our now PDF is downloaded. So we can open this. Here you can see we have now LD heat map ready, and we can directly use it for the publication purpose. So if you are facing any difficulty in the use of this website, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.